I don't know what it could possibly be, folks, but something tells me that I should cover the More Metals mod. And even though it may be as straightforward as content add-ons go, I've kept you hanging long enough, my friend. And even though the mod is a simple one, yes, I believe that was the point. Zay, Dex, X, and Globalistic have asked but a single question. What if More Metals existed in Don't Starve Together, which in turn meant higher tier tools, armor, and weapons? That's what this mod is all about, folks. And welcome to More Metals. And to begin, where exactly do we find these new metals? Well, one can adjust the rarity of the boulders within the configuration menu. However, by default, iron and cobalt rocks are found among the Rocky Lands, dotted about our mosaic biomes, and even within the Dragonfly Desert to boot. There are plenty to go around, but do keep in mind that they aren't exactly renewable, them being modded and all. That said though, both types of metal boulders do appear to drop a healthy amount of their respective resources, so there's that. Cobalt boulders have themselves a blue vein running through them, while iron ones will look more brownish colored, of course. Within both, you will find unique ore and regular minerals, even gold. But how do we forge our new tools once we've actually got the goods? Unfortunately, not through any fancy means, it seems. It is an older mod, so expecting some level of blacksmithing mechanics to be incorporated is pretty darn futile. However, given the efficacy of these tools and such, making them available as simple crafts as all the rest may actually be a good thing. For you see, next to nothing you see here today is going to blow you away. And while that may sound bad, that may actually help the mod more than you think. Because as a whole, it simply adds one extra layer of usefulness to resource gathering and combat while not breaking the pre-existing system. The iron axe, for example, certainly blows the normal one out of the water. However, the luxury axe puts both to shame. So essentially, the mod is just going to create an additional intermediate stepping stone. In most cases, that is, as things are going to work differently with the iron pickaxe. This sucker is actually better than both its normal and luxury counterparts in everything but damage delivered to your enemies' heads. But again, it is nothing out of this world, and that's great stuff. What if we truly did have another material for tools and such? What if stronger or even less stronger things were allowed for more gear for different times? These are but a couple of the questions that mods like these try to answer, and I can appreciate that. But with that general idea of the mod now out of the way, let's just fire through the remaining tools. Yes, the iron hammer boasts just below double the durability of a normal bonker, and will deal 4 more damage per bonk to boot. Time for some whack-a-pork, friends. The iron spear has less durability of that of a normal spear, actually. However, it will deal 42 damage a poke over the original 34. So, there you go. Just a nice, simple, middle-of-the-pack weapon that still could have a place in your arsenal of death. Ah, but if we're talking armor now, we must mention iron and cobalt plates. You will find them under the refinement tab. And while they themselves are inexpensive, both iron and cobalt armor sets will not be. But are they even worth it at the end of the day? Well, yes and no. The iron chestplate is essentially a marble suit, with 10% less protection, but more durability, all the while reducing speeds by but 15% over the marble's 30. While the iron helmet, on the other hand, is all over the bloody place. Its durability places it in the top list of headgear armors in all of Don't Starve, yes. However, that 48% armor protection is by far the lowest across all games. Yeah, even with the cobalt helmet that is coming soon, I'm not really sure where they were going with the helmets. At least that 35% wetness resistance is actually tied for the highest in the game. But speaking of cobalt, let's fire through the cobalt side of all this, shall we? Cobalt itself is just as available as iron, so once more, Do not expect the world from these items. That said, some will boast higher efficiency at the end of the day, but only just. Expect 169 durability and 22.8 damage from a Cobalt Axe over the 144 uses and 21 damage of the Iron One, all the while having the Luxury Axe once again win out. So, if anything, this video has just showed me how ridiculous the Luxury Axe is, especially in comparison to all the other gold tools for Pete's sake, like the Luxury Pickaxe, for example. Because the Cobalt Pickaxe will beat all others, and actually has the same exact stats as the Cobalt Axe. So, there you go. That's easy enough. And in a very similar vein, you can expect the same with the Cobalt Hammer, with it beating out the competition and its stats being the same as the last two bloody tools. Only, you know, it's blue, and the blue hammer is pretty sweet. However, one last slice and dice session here. The Cobalt Spear will also fall short of a normal spear's durability. However, it will up a spear's damage to 45.5 a hit. So kill him dead, friends. And be sure to armor up along the way. And if you're looking to Cobalt armor, things get a bit more interesting in the crafting department. You will be needing to refine some Cobalt plates, yes. However, pieces of iron armor itself will also be needed, alongside a blue gem to boot. Now, are these gonna be worth it? Well, the chest plate is at least. 91% armor protection, which is darn near the highest in the bloody game. 1,170 durability, which is darn near the bloody same. Only 15% less speed, and it's bloody blue. What is there not to love? Ah, right. That would be the Cobalt Helmet. A little more protection and durability over the Iron One, yes, but still lackluster in comparison to even pre-existing headgear. So, yup, just know that, for whatever reason, the headgear in this mod is pretty crappy. But speaking of gear, this mod also just throws in the random ability to craft gears with iron. So yes, that's a thing, I guess. The mod page doesn't even say it itself, but it's a feature. Enjoy. And be sure to enjoy the mod as a whole, as that was more medals for you, everyone. Heck, even if the mod is not one to be overly extravagant, I think we can still all appreciate the idea of potentially having just a new mineral or material to work with in the game. And say Dex X and Globalistic simply just beat clay too, that is all. Oh, know too that new shovels can be crafted and used as well. However, for whatever reason, I couldn't get them to work, but I know that they do. Whatever the case, thanks for your work, friends, and thanks for watching, everyone else. I'll see ya in the next one. Bye-bye.